Good morning and welcome students in today's EVS2 class. Today we are going to see our third chapter, that is Maratha Sardars, the famous house of Bhosles. Period of unrest. As the saints preached devotion of God, the brave Maratha Sardars started a tradition of bravery. So let's see how.
The Maratha Sardars, times before Shivaji. The great state of Maharashtra was now a prisoner of the sultans. About 300 years passed and the people of Maharashtra became used to living badly. People forgot about the great teachings of Jnaneshwar. There was constant fighting and no one was really thinking. It was at this time that Sant Eknath started talking about Sant Jnaneshwar and Sant Namdev again. Listening to his ideas and his messages, some brave Maratha Sardars got good ideas. Maloji and Vithoji Bhosle from Verur were Sardars with the Sultan of Ahmednagar, the Nizam. They decided to work for God and help their people. A Sardar was like a knight. He had his own army and would help the Sultan in wars. In return, the Sultan would give him money or some land called Jagir. The Sardar would look after the Jagir and the people in it and would call himself a Raja. Since they were devotees of Shiva, they built a Shiva temple at Verur. Then they built a huge lake so the farmers could get water to grow crops properly. They continued doing good work so that the people could live better. Soon after, Maloji Bhosle had two sons, Shahaji and Sharifji. This was around the year 1599. Everything was going well for the Bhosles. But then again, disaster struck. When Shahaji was 5 years old, his father Maloji died in a battle. Then his mother Umabai and his uncle Vithoji looked after him and his brother. When Shahaji was 10 years old, his marriage to Jizau Jadhav was fixed. Jizau was pleasant, intelligent, and the daughter of a brave Maratha Sardar, Lakhuji Jadhav of Sindhkhed. So two great Maratha families came together as Shahaji and Jizau got married. A few years later, Sharifji was married too. His bride was Durgabai. Umabai was very happy. Both her sons were doing well and had good wives too. Even Vithoji was happy. He had 8 brave sons, Sambhaji, Kheloji, Manwaji, Nagoji, Parsoji, Trambakji, Kakkaji and Maloji. All 10 cousins cared a lot about each other. The Jadhavs of Sindhkhed and the Bhosles of Verur were both very brave Maratha families. In fact, most of the Maratha Sardars were really brave, but they all worked for the Sultan. Maloji and Vithoji sons of Babaji Bhosle, were both brave and clever. The chief minister of Nizam Shah saw this and wanted the brothers to keep working for the Sultan. So, he asked the Sultan to award the Jagir of Pune and Supe to Maloji Bhosle. After Maloji died, the Jagir was transferred to Shahaji Raje. No one realized that the Sultan could rule because they were all so strong and brave. If they all had decided not to support the Sultan, they could have easily become emperors themselves. But they just kept on fighting with each other and never came together as one group. And at a time like this, a really terrible accident happened at Devgiri. As the court day came to an end, the Jadhavs and Bhosles were leaving the Nizam's court. Suddenly, an elephant started running around and hurting people. The Jadhavs wanted to kill the elephant immediately, and the Bhosles wanted to calm the elephant down. Dattaji Jadhav, who was Lakhuji's son, was very excited and angry. He killed the elephant and then started attacking the Bhosles. Sambhaji Bhosle then attacked him and killed him. The bravest Maratha families were fighting with one another. And of course, it did not end there. Lakhuji Jadhav was very angry. He came with his sword to attack the Bhosles. First, he attacked Shahaji. But Shahaji got hurt only a little. Then Lakhuji attacked Sambhaji and killed him. This was in the year 1623. Jizau was terribly sad. She was about to have a baby at that time. She had lost a brother and a brother-in-law on the same day. The Maratha Sardars, unrest in Maharashtra, and the birth of Sambhaji Raje. Just like the Bhosles of Verur and the Jadhavs of Sindhkhed, there were other brave Maratha families too. Some of them were Nimbarkars of Phaltan, Ghorpades of Mudhol, Mores of Jawali, etc. Jizau had a baby boy. She named him Sambhaji. Sambhaji was Jizabai's eldest son. Quarrels were happening everywhere. The brave Marathas were all fighting with each other, being loyal to the Sultan and protecting him. They did not understand that they had to stay united. When would they realize that they could be the rulers themselves? The brave Marathas were continuously fighting with each other. They were also helping and protecting the evil sultans. They were all good warriors. One thing they didn't understand was that they could rule well too. The Bhosles and Jadhavs had both killed a member of each other's family and could not be friends anymore. In the meantime, Shahaji's bravery was increasing day by day. The Sultan of Delhi attacked Nizam Shah in 1624. The battle was at Bhatwadi near Ahmednagar. Shahaji and Sharifji both fought bravely for the Nizam Shah and defeated the Sultan of Delhi. Sharifji died in this battle. Shahaji also fought against the Adil Shah of Bijapur and defeated him. The Marathas were brave and strong enough to fight for the Sultan, but they never thought of fighting against him. And through all this, Jizau was about to have a baby again. But there were more problems to come. The Maratha Sardars, Shahaji Raje becomes Sir Lashkar. Sultan Nizam Shah had a minister who was quite jealous of these brave Maratha Sardars. One day, the minister told the Nizam Shah that the Jadhavs were wicked. The Nizam Shah immediately believed him and made a plan to kill the Jadhavs. This was in 1636. Soon after, one day, the Jadhavs came to visit the Nizam Shah and bowed before him. The Nizam got up and left. Then his other generals quickly drew their swords and cut off the Jadhavs' heads. The brave Lakhuji and his three sons, Akloji, Raghoji and Yashwantrao, all killed just because the Sultan felt like it. And Jizau lost her father and her brothers for no reason too. A few days later, Shahaji's cousin's wife, Kheloji Rao Bhosle's wife, was kidnapped. So, it was a really horrible time for the Bhosle Jadhav family. Shahaji was very angry and he stopped working for the Nizam. He joined the other Sultan, Adil Shah. Adil Shah was happy to have Shahaji in his court and gave him the title of Sar Lashkar. Sar means head and Lashkar means soldiers. So, Sar Lashkar means the head of the soldiers or the army chief. In the meantime, Nizam Shah's minister killed him and became the Nizam himself. He called Shahaji back to join him. So, Shahaji started leading the Nizam's army. At that time, the Emperor of Delhi, Shahjahan, attacked the Nizam's kingdom and Shahaji had to fight to protect the whole kingdom too. However, Shahjahan kidnapped the Nizam's son and Shahaji had to surrender. That finished off the Nizam's kingdom. Shahaji then worked in Bangalore under Adil Shah. He worked very loyally and bravely and was given a jagir there.
So students, I hope everybody took active participation in this lesson. Let us find it out by a quiz.